He nods and looks back at you. Then I'm ready, and I guess I won't be needing any of this street gear I've been collecting, so you can have it. And thanks for everything. So we got Dull Strike and Light Metal. And that cube we have to look at. And he's leaving. This poor girl's by herself now. Avina is playing her flute in front of the empty space where the house used to be. She looks up at your approach. I'm glad you convinced Zeb to go to the House of Empty Time. I don't think he would have ever been happy here. You're a good person, ma'am. It was our house. Me, Zeb, and Nim. They're my friends. They're almost my family. I used to be from outside the city, and now I'm here. Still nothing with the Stitcher. You have one kid left. If we help it rejoin its friends, its family, its kind. Imagine if I can open that. This facade is all that remains of a house. The rest has collapsed into the sea, hundreds of meters below. There's that thing. We can interact with that. I wonder if she has anything to say now. The house fell down. Sorry, guys. She doesn't remember this stuff.
I'm going.
Let me just go look over here, because I don't remember what this thing is. There was a lady standing here. Ready. She's not here now. Mother Tamaz is gone. Her fate is not a mystery. Over the edge of the cliff you see the ruins of her house, and the streaks of bloody fingers scrabbling at the rock. She fell into the distant sea, along with her home. I didn't realize she actually had a house here. It is possible that the midwife left some of her valuables behind, and she is certainly not coming back for them. So let's search the rubble. We got beads of Mother Tamaz. In a little stone cistern on the broken roof, you find a long string of strange-looking beads, the same beads that Mother Tamaz was clutching in her hands when you last saw her. You pocket them and step away from the edge.
Ready.
You take a look around the ruins of this house, but find nothing else worth salvaging. Alright, now we gotta look at our stuff here. Before we sign off, we got a quest item, interdimensional puzzle box. We can use it. This is a small metallic cube recovered from the ruins of a collapsed house in Cliff's Edge. It is etched with tiny symbols, but the means of opening the box is not obvious from a cursory visual inspection. At first glance, this metallic cube seems simple enough. Then you see light reflecting off a myriad of tiny silvery panels within. Behind them is an intricate network of coils and springs. Something rattles within. Examine. You raise the cube to eye level and shake it again. Nothing moves within, but once again you hear the rattle of an object trapped inside. Something rough grazes the edges of your thumb. Turning the cube sideways, you see a finely etched diagram, a labyrinthine network of circuits. It means nothing to you. Perhaps one of the experts in the machinery lore in the city may be able to make sense of it. What's his name from the Order of Truth? Talks about machinery lore. You study the diagram on the side of the box further, but can still make no sense of it. Perhaps showing this to someone more skilled in machinery lore can help. Let's smell it. Beneath the expected greasy stench of metal, you detect salt. The mingled aroma of heated metal and stone, a fearsome sense of nostalgia grips you for a moment, tied to absolutely nothing that you can recall. We can't smell it again. We can squeeze it. You press the box between your palms and it collapses. Oh, I thought I broke it. With a satisfying hissing series of clicks. When you let go, it immediately springs back into seemingly rigid shape. Click, clack, click. Alright, what else we got? We have a dull strike. Slightly slick to the touch, this flexible ring can fit any size. When worn, it deadens sensation in that appendage. Worn for a longer time, it is known to slowly kill the nerves, leaving the wearer completely insensate. Well, I don't want to do that. Light metal. This metal sphere is lighter than air. It is comfortably warm to the touch. If unsecured, it starts to float away, accelerating slowly. The origin of the sphere is unknown. Can't use that either. And then we got beads of Mother Tamaz. This long string of beads belong to a midwife in Cliff's Edge. Each bead on a string is distinct and unique, representing one of the babies she delivered over the course of her long career. Touching one of the beads will put you into very brief mental contact with whoever that bead represents. Okay. That could be very helpful. Dried blood coats many of the unique beads strung along a chain. It could be from any of the births Mother Tamaz ended the birth. Or it might be her own. Touch a bead. You close your hand over a random bead. Threads of the person it represents weave into a tapestry of murmurs that floods your senses. She is seeking, seeking, always seeking, behind gates, beneath flesh. You release the bead and your mind clears. You close your hand over a random bead. Threads of the person it represents weave into a tapestry of murmurs that floods your senses. She carves a tunnel through the blackened wood. On the side, she etches stars and the curving paths of worlds, or hurtling ruins. She hums through the hollow. The air quakes. He remembers the brittle crack of bone, the blood in the dust. He remembers the taste and smiles. She sings with her hands. The music echoes. She echoes. Stepping, climbing between cable, cord, and port, the murmur of the city below is like the whispering of waves. He hasn't spoken to anyone in 7 years. He lives in a cloud of roasted smoke, amid a tangle of shapes and shapeless flesh. Same. Hollow sockets. Thorns of ice plucked out the eyes, and whatever they saw, grief withered by screaming. Breathless, blinded by tears, he kneels on the estate's warm stone. With slow fingers, he traces where she slept when she was young. These are like randomly appearing. Even in his silent moments, he hears the sound of pursuit. He thinks he deserves it. He is made of bird bones wrapped in thin spotted flesh. In him is a hunger for change. His half-formed dreams are as high as a tower of stars. His doubt is enough to bring them tumbling down. Think I read that one? She thinks of the daggers she's dropped into the waves. She wonders if the tides have stripped the blood from them yet. A surface as cold as snow, torn flesh and shattered bone. Shock lingers like a cloud of icy ink. She binds her fingers into fists, haunted by fear, and longing for the ring where the fear dies. I don't think these are gonna mean anything, guys. She is cold, broken, still, cradled in the waves. Wings like shards of stained glass, stolen gems, broken sunsets. Information flows like... sipped like nectar. She samples. Tastes. Okay. So I could sign off, but I'm not going to.
Yes, child.
How do we unseal that hatch?
Happy to help.
Heading back to the Order of Truth to see what he knows about this cube. That would be, Min of Tan Liang. It's a performance. I want to talk to a performer. I sing of sorrows, jagged songs, of failed right and righteous
yes.
wrongs. Very nice. Why do they have so many buildings here? Do not stare at people, Gorga. It is not polite.
Herp.
That's not polite either, Gorga. Oh, this isn't Government Square.
We shall see.
We shall see Government Square.
All right.
Need to go back, see if this priest knows anything about this thing.
We shall see.
I need more leads on this murder case.
Right.
I kind of wonder if it comes down to just asking the right person, like anywhere in the city. Perception check, or the murderer gets nervous and reveals himself kind of thing. Hail, Mr. Min. Can you make sense of the diagram on this puzzle box? Min takes the box carefully, studies it, then hands it back with a whistle. That's no diagram. That's a machine language. I recognize a few words. That one, he says, pointing to a symbol, means copy. That one is stability, or strength. He shakes his head. I'd love to untangle this for you, but you're better off going right to the source and asking the foreman themselves. Okay. And he thinks, what's that? Quit my position and spend several months deciphering this? Well, No, I shouldn't. He's really tempted. The foreman in the underbelly. Okay.
As you wish.
I need to see if they can help me make something to get to the changing gods. Former lair or whatever.
Of course.
At least this way we'll come down right in the middle of them.
On it.
Hail! The option there. Probably asking him, but let me just see if this one has anything to say. Interesting how we interact with them, not talk to them. Hello again, Artisan says. What do you need? What can you tell me about the diagram on this puzzle box?
My studies have borne fruit.
Press it against my abdomen, it says cheerfully. I could scan it, but my plating's the best bet for sensing delicate work. You do so. The box clinks against the construct's metal skin. Machine-based language, it says, delighted. Haven't run into that for a while. It says, to my daughter, let this sealed gift occupy your time until I return, and I will return. That is a promise. One other thing. Two interlocking sigils, each one meaning hand, appear next to promise. It doesn't seem like it's part of the message, though. Artisan makes a satisfied sound. Strange business. Machines don't have daughters, so I'd imagine we're looking at someone who knew our language. Mysterious. Don't you want to know where it came from? In this city? You can't kick over a stone without finding a relic from an age and an aeon ago. You're talking to one, remember? Go enjoy the sunlight for me. Alright. Let's get the master form and has anything to say. You're back, the frozen construct says, glaring down at you. We don't train novices here. Why are you here? What do you want? Out with it. Glad to. Out with it. I'm trying to reach the lair of the Stichus. Can you build me a digging construct? Yes, the master foreman declares, glowing eyes scanning the ceiling. Stalkers, bring me the war machine casing from Z-19, the intelligence nexus from B-2, and the scouring claws from my personal collection. It lowers its eyes to you. Now, let's talk payment. I don't want to destroy all the eggs. I don't even want to fight them. But, I need to get to the Changing God, and I could use that to get there too, right? Master Artisan says, make sure you include the cost of repairing the damage done by unleashing an insane war machine with molten claws on the city. Stalkers, stand by, the master foreman shouts. Audinson's not wrong, it says in a much lower voice. For once, that might be more construct than you need. Give me a moment. The eyes wink out for several seconds. Engines embedded in the construct's chest roar, then the eyes reignite. Find me the intact corpse of a Stichus. Oh, I know where that is. We can reinforce the carapace and recover the spatial memory system if it's not too far gone. Should lead you straight to its lair, and since you're supplying the materials, I'll waive the cost. Excellent. I'm not going to use the... That we kill the Stichus up top? By the fallen home? No. I found a Stichus corpse in a dead-end tunnel on the far side of the underbelly. Will that work for a digging construct? The construct's flickering eyes become a bonfire. Fetchers, it roars. Artificers, report to supervisor for a new project. Hours later, the workers trudge back. The supervisor makes a complicated hand sign to the master foreman. You'll find the construct where you left it, ready for use. The construct grumbles. I should have asked you to pay after all. Supervisor says it's a masterpiece. Its eyes dim as it descends into deeper thought. But no, a deal's a deal. Fine, are we done here? Farewell. Yes, yes, stay clear of the forge. Where did he say it was? Shaky foundations. The master foreman agreed to create a digging automaton for me, but it requires the intact corpse of a Stichus. I'll have to look around for one. The foreman have used the Stichus corpse I found to fabricate a digging automaton. I can now use it to reach any location underground, including the Stichus lair. It's waiting for me in the tunnel where I found the Stichus corpse. Cool.
Carithus. A word. Why? Yes, Vince. So clever.
They're so silly. I have a willow-woven garment. Bee resistance. Crossbow. What does she have? Buzzer. Sting charge for her. Okay. Another buzzer thing, I think, already. Or do I not? Do I not? Did you find any cool weapons for the last cast off? That's alright. Go get this thing. Oh! Now this isn't something we can get in. It's not big enough. Stichus automaton. I guess it just burrows through for us. And we follow it. The animated corpse of the Stichus you unearthed towers above you, waiting for your commands. Examine. It isn't difficult spotting the additions that the Master Foreman's workers have made. Opalescent metal fills its wounds, and the mangled claw has been replaced with a mechanical one. Coils of ridged cables spring from patch to patch before plunging into its thorax. Some of its eyes have changed as well. Faint glowing lights blink from otherwise empty sockets. Dull light shines on the rainbow-sheen metal that covers the creature's wounds and on the cables connecting them. You aren't sure what the Master Foreman's workers have done to the Stichus, but you can't deny that it worked. Wave your hand in the creature's eyes to see if there's any reaction. The thing's pupils blaze brighter at the passage of your hand, but that's the extent of its response. Its eyes blaze like distant coals, but the creature does not otherwise respond. I want you to dig a tunnel to take me somewhere. A shuddering click from behind the creature's blinking eyes is your only response. You sense it is waiting for you to give it a destination. random direction. Take me to the Changing Gods Sanctuary. I don't want to destroy all those eggs. And they're gonna battle me if they find me there. As you emerge into a rough-hewn chamber, laced with golden filaments, the automaton makes a series of agitated clicks and begins to retreat toward the tunnel. It seems that the creature cannot, or will not, go any further. This place smells faintly of ozone, and the air crackles with static electricity. It doesn't feel like a place that your sire would have built, but the entrance to his sanctuary must be somewhere nearby. Alright, see you later.
Updated my journal.
It says logbook in the text though. Updated my journal. I found my way to the Stichus lair. The entrance to the Changing God Sanctuary is somewhere within. Okay. So they're here anyway, the Stichus lair. Addendum added to this. Or I've already read it. Oh, look at my pointer. It's like gushing tentacles or something. Stichus lair. Wow. All this stuff, cool stuff. That I don't know what the hell it does. Anyway, thanks for watching, guys. See you in the next one. We investigate the Stichus lair. Endure. In enduring? Restaurant.